Hey Stampers, it's Jackie Bolhuis from Klompen Stampers. I've got some fun cards to share with you today that are going to use the Incredible Like You stamp set. Now, it might be one you missed in the catalog because it's actually designed to go along with a card kit, but it stands alone awesomely. I actually have the card kit. I haven't done it yet, but first I broke open my stamp set and decided to just play with the stamp set, and that's what I'm going to share with you today. So let's go ahead, flip the camera down, and first let me remind you, don't forget to hit that little red button down there and subscribe to the channel. And if you like my videos, please give me a thumbs up and give me a shout by leaving me a comment so that I know what you like. And I'll keep stamping quick and easy cards for you 3 times a week. So can't wait to share with you on and on and on. So let's flip the camera down and look at today's projects. This stamp set is gorgeous. And there's so many lovely pieces, as well as some awesome, awesome, awesome words. I love the font of the words. They're nice and big and bold, and then you can just build with these stamps and do whatever you want with them. So I'm gonna give you some tips for stamping them today, and then I'll give you a closer look at our cards again. Now, the first thing I'm gonna do is I selected the greeting I want, and we're gonna stamp that in black. I tend to use black almost all the time for my greetings. I just feel like it pops. I know some people like to use the color that they're stamping with, but I think black just gives you that popping look with that greeting. So it pops off and then your stamping just kind of stands on its own. So anyway, we stamped on a piece of Whisper White, and then I am using the 2-inch circle punch to punch it out. Now, you're gonna see why in a second I needed to do that first. Now, I have cut out a rectangle here. Can you see the stitching? This is using those stitched rectangle framelits that you keep seeing me use. I'm in love with these guys, so sorry if you keep seeing them on almost every card that I make. This one happens to be, let's see if we can measure on our paper here. It looks like it is about 4 1/8 by 2 3/4-ish or so. But the beauty of this, you don't have to measure when you cut. You just grab a scrap paper and you cut it out. Now I'm gonna kind of stamp this one for you to show how I went about it and give you a few tips as we go. I started out, oh wait, you know what? First I gotta show you something really cool. I get asked quite often, how do you come up with the color combinations that you use? I love to use my catalog and the different designer series papers. So what I did for this, both of these cards actually, one I used this paper on and one I didn't, but I started out by going to the catalog here and I looked up the floral romance paper and I looked to see what colors were in it. There's Fresh Fig, Mossy Meadow, Pear Pizzazz, and Petal Pink. And I'm like, perfect color combination. So I just grabbed those pads. We got Petal Pink, Fresh Fig, Pear Pizzazz, Mossy Meadow, and that's what I'm gonna use to stamp my card. So that's where that color combination came from. So we're gonna just start out with the Petal Pink and our striped stamp here. And we're gonna just go ahead and try to get it as straight as we can right across our rectangle, like so. Now, as you can see from our original card, I'm gonna center this, kind of centered, I guess, over those stripes. So all of my stamping, I want it to appear like it's coming out from underneath that. So I will hold on to this quite a bit as I'm stamping, just to kind of get that placement. Hope that makes sense. Now, this is a two-step stamp, and when I two-step stamp, more often than not, I will use one color ink pad. Some people like to use a darker pad and a lighter pad. Well, I enjoy using just one, and I will, the first stamping, which needs to be lighter, I'll stamp on my scrap paper first, then I'll stamp where I want it. So I know by kind of holding this, I can eyeball it, and then we'll stamp that one there. And then we'll hold it again, scrap paper, and kind of eyeball it about right there. Oop, it's stuck. Then we can take the second one that's gonna go on top of it. And let's see if I can do this without getting my whole head in the camera. There's one, and we'll flip over to this side, and we'll get that one. So there are those. Now, let's get our greens here. These two stamps, you could actually put these together. I think they're meant to be one on top of each other and as a two-step, but I actually kind of liked them separately. So we're gonna go on scrap paper once again because I want a lighter tone on here. We'll do another one coming off this way. And once again, I'm just being mindful as to where the circle's going to be so that we can fill in around it and have everything coming off. Now, oops, we're gonna take the other piece that I could put on top, but this is the one I liked it on its own. We're just going with a darker color. So this is the Mossy Meadow. And we'll stick one of those in like so. You know, maybe we could even bring one out that way. And then there is the other piece here that's more of a stem, I guess we'll call it. And we're gonna put that one, we'll put one in there, and then we'll put, let's see, let's put one right there, and maybe right there. See how we're doing as far as building to cover up where our circle's going to go. Then on my original card, I used the piece that has three little flowers on it. But then as I started playing it on the second one, I think I like this one a little bit better. So we're gonna go back to that fresh fig and use this flower and just put it at the end of all three of our branches, or wherever we have a branch. That one might be hidden. Let's see, stick one there. We'll stick a couple in here like so. So now, looks like kind of a mess there, but when we put our words there, it just looks like everything's coming out from underneath the words. So those are my tips for stamping this card and putting together a card where you're layering something on top of it. I will have pictures of the card outside and inside on the blog post. There will be a link down in the description of the video to lead you there. And I'll list all of the colors and all of the supplies that I use so that if you'd like to make these cards, you certainly can. So there's the first one. Then here's the second one, which I really did the same way. I punched out my circle first so I could see where I was going there. We've got two layers of those stitched rectangles on this one. And then this one, I did use a piece of the Designer Series paper from that pack that I pulled the colors from. So, and there's our words in that one. So I hope you enjoy these two cards. Like I said, this stamp set goes with a card kit that is super cool. And I'll be showing you how to put the cards together in the card kit probably in the next coming weeks or so. But for today, I was just playing with the stamp set and I fell in love with it, especially the greetings. So as always, if you have questions, make sure to ask me. If you need a Stampin' Up! Catalog because you don't have a demonstrator already, I would love to be your demonstrator. Just go to my website and up at the top, there's a link on, or a link that you can click on to request a catalog and I'll get one out to you. So again, if you have questions, leave me a comment. I'm happy to help you in any way that I can. So until I stamp again with you guys, have a stamp happy day.